go.
He gave him a win and a loss.
I was going to say, I told him that, or he, I guess he just wanted to confirm with me that that's what he needed to do. I don't know if this was prior, but apparently it had already taken.
It was like 10 after 6 when he called me and said it was a 6 o'clock game.
Yeah.
And he told me that it was regular. Well, regular was played at 5 o'clock, and that score got put in. The next game was hits and somebody else right out of line. That's the one that he put. He said, no, 6 o'clock. Because, you know, they got to do it before the top of the third. But he had team sideline login, you know, he knew what to do on that.
So that's funny because he called me like at 6:25. So it had to be right at the third.
10 after 6 is when he called me. I thought Dave's son was supposed to be lucky, but I don't know his name. But it didn't sound like his son.
Birthday girl. Two outs. Yes, Frankel. Frankella. You can see who it was that actually worked out here.
Supposed to, but I have
all I've got is a phone number. Somebody I didn't recognize.
I wrote the number down. It's a 214. That was Grand Prairie. I think it was. But he couldn't get any bus code or anything.
Really.
Well, And I'm not talking a quick minute, I'm talking 30 minutes in a crack.
Who's that?
Sean Jackson.
I hadn't talked or heard from him in ages.
Well, it was funny. Friday night, Robert Ivey, the guy that worked for the city, called Bobby and told him he had heard that John.
Oh.
Well, come to find out, there's a Sean Jackson. There is a James Gary. And they called him JJ. And James Gary, they also called him JJ.
Okay, let's go.